Hello dear students, welcome to unit 6 of the FCCN, which is based on physical MAC layer standards and switching. In the beginning we shall see about the LAN hardware. The LAN hardware or connecting devices for the LAN consist of passive hubs, active hubs, bridges, two-layer switches, routers, three-layer switches and gateways. So let us consider this one by one. This is the five categories of the connecting devices. And this diagram shows at which layer these devices appear in the LAN. Passive hub is considered to be below the physical layer. The repeater or the hub, or also called the active hub, is essentially at the physical layer. A bridge or two-layer switch is considered to be at two different layers, that is data link layer and physical layer, whereas the router or a three-layer switch is considered at, it works as the three layers, that is the network layer, data layer, link layer and physical layer. Whereas the gateway is a kind of switch which works at all the five layers, that is up to the application layer. So let us see all these devices in detail one by one. So starting with a repeater connecting the two LAN segments. The purpose of the repeater is to increase the length of the LAN. Many LANs have limitations on the wire which connects it. In the different types of LAN, that particular limit is different. So that in that particular LAN, the kind of the cable determines it, and we have already seen in some other class. So here, if we want to increase that particular length, then in that case what we do is that we break that particular cable into the number of segments, and between the segments we can put this particular repeater. So this particular LAN has got two different segments and one repeater. So here the physical length of the LAN can be increased in this fashion. So as discussed, the repeater, it connects the segments of a LAN. The repeater forwards every frame, and it has no filtering capacity. So whatever input it gets, it forwards on to the other port. Okay, so it has, and it has got two ports, and whatever it receives on one port, it forwards it as it is to the other port, or whatever it receives on the other port, it blindly forwards it to the first port. So a repeater, it is a regenerator and it is not an amplifier. So let us see this particular diagram as how the repeater works. So here you can see that on a segment of the LAN, when the signal travels on that particular segment, it may decay, and as it reaches the repeater, then what repeater does is that it regenerates that particular signal. So this particular decayed or corrupted signal, though it is corrupted, but we are able to it is possible to recognize whether it represents a 0 or it represents 1, and this particular repeater will regenerate that particular signal, or it will strengthen that particular signal. So we can see that the weaker signal is converted to a strong signal by the repeater, and it does it in both the direction, that is right to left. This shows the right to left transmission, whereas this shows the left to right transmission. Now let us see the hierarchy of the hubs. The hub has the filtering capability. The hubs can be connected in this particular fashion, hierarchy, that is one hub can be connected to the another hubs, and to these particular hubs the host can be connected. As discussed, it has a the filtering capability. The bridge has the filtering capability. It can check the destination address of the frame and decide if the frame should be forwarded or dropped. If a frame is to be forwarded, the decision must specify the port. Bridge has a table that maps the address to the ports. Actually, this is related to the hubs, and in the next diagram we shall see how a bridge is. Okay, so this is the actual bridge, and this particular bridge has got the filtering capability. So to demonstrate that, you can consider we can take one example here. So if a frame is destined for the station, this is the address of that particular station. So this is the physical address of that particular station. Then in that particular bridge, there is a table called filtering table, and that particular table tells which is the outgoing port for a particular station. So this particular station, which is ending with 142, so it has got the outgoing port to be 1. So if according to this particular table, so frames for this host leaves through port 1, therefore there is no need for forwarding that particular frame, and the frame is dropped. Okay, so if it is received, if any frame is received at port 1, which is having this particular destination, then this frame is dropped. This frame will not be forwarded to port 2 by this particular bridge. Okay, so this frame will be on this segment of the LAN only. Okay, on the other hand, if the frame for 141 arrives at port 2, okay, so if this host or this host sends a frame and which arrives at this particular port 2, then it will be forwarded to the port 1 by this particular bridge. Okay, so this table shows that 142, it is its outgoing port is 1, and because the frame is received at port 2, so it will be forwarded to this particular port 1. So the bridge has got the forwarding and blocking function. So referring to the table, it either forwards a frame or it blocks the frame. So in the first case, LAN 2 remains free of traffic. In the second case, both LANs have the traffic. In this example, we have shown that the two port bridge, but in reality, a bridge usually has got more than two ports. So the earlier diagram, it has been elaborated here. You can see this particular diagram carefully. The bridge just see the MAC addresses, and it does not modify or change those particular MAC address or physical addresses. Now let us see the transparent bridges. Transparent bridge is a bridge in which the stations are completely unaware of the bridge's existence. If the bridge is added or deleted from the system, the recompression of that particular station is necessary. So according to IEEE 802.1D specification, the system equipped with transparent bridge must have these three criteria. First, frames must be forwarded from one station to another. The forwarding table is automatically made by learning frame movements in the network, and loops in the system must be prevented. So these are the three different capabilities of a transparent frame. So consider this particular configuration. So in this configuration, there is a bridge, and this particular bridge is connecting, it is having three ports, and it is connecting three different LANs, that is LAN 1, LAN 2 and LAN 3, and it has got three different ports. In the beginning, the table for this particular bridge do not contain any entry, so that particular table is empty. And in such cases, if any port receives a frame, then that particular frame will be forwarded to the remaining ports. But as the frames are received by the ports, it learns the location of the stations in those particular LAN. So how it learns, let us see. When station A sends a frame to D, the bridge does not have an entry for either D or A. The frame goes out from all the three ports, and the port frames floods the network. However, looking at the source address, the bridge learns that station A must be located on the LAN connected to port 1. So this means that the frame destined for A in the future must be sent out through port 1. The bridge adds this entry to its table, and the table has its first entry now. Okay, so the first entry is made to the table after A sends a frame to D. Then what next? When station E sends a frame to station A, the bridge has an entry for A. So it forwards the frame only to port 1. There is no flooding. In addition, it uses the source address of the frame E to add a second entry to the table. So this is what happens when that E sends a frame to A. So this particular frame is sent only on port 1, because this bridge knows that A is connected to port 1, and based on that it adds one entry to it. And one more example, when station B sends a frame to C, the bridge has no entry for C. So once again, it floods the network and adds one more entry to the table. So this is what is the situation of the table after B sends a frame to C. However, this particular frame will be sent on the all other ports also. So the process of learning continues as the bridge forwards the frame. Now let us consider the looping problem in the bridges. Okay, so whenever there are more than one bridges in the LAN, then there can be a problem of loop. So for that purpose, consider this configuration. There are two LANs. In the first LAN, there are two stations A and B, and in the second LAN, there are two stations C and D. Now, what happens is that station A sends a frame to station D. So this particular frame will be received, will be sent by A, it will be received by B, it will be received by bridge 1 on port A, and it will be received by bridge 2 on port A. After that, what happens, because that particular the tables of the bridge 1 and bridge 2, they are empty, so the bridge 1 sends that to port 2, then the bridge 2 also send it to the port 2. So two copies of the frame on the LAN exist here. So here the entries are like this. For the bridge 1, it and the entry is like this. For the address of A is port 1, and that is the outgoing port for the host A is port 1, and B also note that the outgoing port for the station is port 1. But now, because these particular frames, they are on the LAN 2, so this particular frame forwarded by bridge 1 goes to C, it goes to D, and it also goes to bridge 2, port 2 of bridge 2. Whereas this frame coming out of bridge 2, port 2, will also go to the host C, host D, and port 2 of bridge 1. So because both the ports they receive this particular each other's frame, so what they do is that they alter their tables. That is, they write there that the source address for A is port 2 now, okay, and eventually what they do, they again send that particular frame to send that particular frame onto the port 1. So here you can see that the two copies of the frame on the LAN 1, so this is sent out by bridge 1 and this is sent out by bridge 2, and again these would be received by the bridges, and these particular copies now they keep on repeatedly sent from LAN 1 to LAN 2. So this particular problem is termed as the looping problem. So this particular problem can be solved by removing the loops in the LAN. So there are many techniques to remove the loops in the LAN. So you can break the connections such that the frames won't be sent to some of the ports. So some ports they go blocking. So various algorithms can be used for this purpose, and that eventually the network of this particular LAN and bridges can be drawn as a graph, and the some of the lines in the graphs are removed considering the shortest path. So you can see here that we can find out the shortest path, and we can find out a tree starting from the root. Okay, so this particular B1 bridge becomes the root, and only these shortest path connections are shown, and the others they are removed. So you can see here that now our the original LAN is like this. So the bridge 1 will not block the traffic on either of its ports, so is with the bridge 4 and bridge 2, whereas bridge 3 will not forward anything to port 2 and 3 what it has received on port 1, and bridge 5 will not send anything on bridge on port 1 whatever it has received at port 2. Okay, so this will avoid looping in the LANs. Now the router is a three layer device that routes packets based on their logical addresses. So it is host to host addressing. A router normally connects LANs, WANs in the internet and has a routing table. This is used for making decisions about the route. The routing tables are normally dynamic and updated using routing protocols. Now the figure shows on the next slide, it is a part of the internet that uses router to connect LANs and WANs. So this is a router, and a router can be connected to number of LANs either, or it can also be connected to a WAN also. So number of routers have been shown here. These routers, they work at three layers, that is physical layer, the data link layer, and the network layer. And the last part is the gateways. Although some textbooks use the term gateway and router interchangeably, most of the literature distinguishes between these two. A gateway is normally a computer that operates in all the five layers of the internet or seven layers of the OSI model. A gateway takes an application message, reads it, and interprets it. This message, that is, that it can be used as a connecting device between two internet works that use the different models. That is, this means that the connecting, when we want to connect the devices between the two internet works, then we use this particular gateways. For example, a network designed to use OSI model can be connected to another network using the internet model. The gateway connecting the two systems can take a frame as it arrives from the first system, move it up to the OSI application layer, and remove the message. So this is the summary of what we have discussed in this particular lecture. You can ask the questions, or you can refer to the literature which is there, which you can find on the Google Classroom, or you can use the for discussion the WhatsApp group. Thank you. We shall meet in the next lecture.